The Land Rover Discovery has an auxiliary fuel burning heater, which ignites on start up at less than 5 degC to aid cold start and heat up the cabin quicker. It burns a small amount of diesel and normally you wouldn't be aware it was running. You probably wouldn't even know it was there. But I know it's there, and I know when it is on. How? Because during a recent cold snap, the car began smoking like a laboratory beagle on startup and didn't stop for 10 minutes. If you're moving quickly, you'd not notice much happening, but if you're moving along more slowly, it emits more light-colored smoke than a papal conclave. The internet reckons that fuel-burning heaters might, occasionally, smoke a little on startup if there's some stale diesel in the pipe after it has been used for the first time in, say, months. But this wasn't a little. This emitted from the underbody in sufficient quantity that when I parked up to first see what it was, I did it near a fire station. It eased, and so confident was I that I drove it round the block, no smoke, then parked it up at home. But starting it again later from cold, it did the same thing, so I called Land Rover Assist. Things began well. They offered a Land Rover technician between 3 p.m. and 5 p.m., or the AA right away. I chose the Land Rover BOD, but he was cancelled at 3.45 p.m. because of an overrunning previous job. It happens. So, they said, he can come tomorrow, or you can have the AA straight away, and we'll arrange a replacement car if that doesn't help. Half an hour later, then, Andy from the AA was agreeing that the smoke was excessive, diagnosed the fuel burning heater, but couldn't fix it, so 20 minutes after he left, about 6 p.m., Land Rover Assist called to say an evacuee with my name on it should be in Milton Keynes the next morning, if I didn't mind taking the Discovery over there. Sure, said I, only in the morning it turned out it wasn't going to be ready until 4 p.m., at which point I took the sensible option and pulled out the fuel-burning heater fuse. I booked the car in when both dealer and I are free, though this isn't until April, when they're still so busy they can't give me a replacement car. Land Rover Assist called again and told me they'd ask the dealer to move things closer. They haven't, but I haven't had time to chase it either. Meantime, I think the Discovery takes a mite longer to heat up the cabin and is, perhaps, a bit noisier on cold start, though I might be imagining it, but otherwise you still wouldn't know it had a fuel-burning heater, even though it doesn't, if you follow me. Everything else is normal and functioning well. The mileage is up to 22,400 and I've had to pop in another 10 liters of AdBlue, which keeps the usage at 1 liter every 350 miles or thereabouts. And the 99% of the car that's still working is still great.